News organizations around the world use Google Analytics to understand their audience's behavior on their website. But how can that same information best be used by editors and journalists? That's the question that a free-of-cost product called Realtime Content Insights aims to answer. Developed by Google, Realtime Content Insights, which we call RCI, helps newsrooms understand their audiences and make editorial decisions informed by real-time data. It's a complementary product to another tool that Google developed called News Consumer Insights, or NCI, that is more often used by business leaders at news companies. If you're interested in NCI as well, check out our separate video on that. I'm Ian Leroy from the Google News Initiative. In this video, we'll give you a quick overview of RCI, and we will suggest ways that news organizations around the world can use this product. Start by going to the URL on the screen and beneath this video, goo.gle/datatools. You'll see several different technologies that the Google News Initiative offers free of charge. Click on Real-Time Content Insights. Before the tour of the site, we want to show you how to connect your own data to RCI. Click on the button at the top to sign in, logging in with the email address associated with your Google Analytics account. The website works whether you have a free-of-cost or paid version of Google Analytics. Once you log in, the demo data on screen will be replaced with real data from your website. If you have any trouble logging into the site, try deleting your cookies in your browser. If that doesn't work, you can email us at contactgni@google.com. On the homepage of RCI, you will see several different sources of information. At the top, you'll see the most popular articles on your website. You'll see the headline and photo for that article, and, more importantly, you will see 5 circles. Let's start by talking about each of these circles and what they tell you. The first number, shown in the black circle, tells you the number of readers on a story right now. The second number in the white circle tells you the number of views in the past 30 minutes. Both of these metrics can be helpful for capturing a snapshot of current and recent behavior on your site. Third, you will see a circle with an L or a C. Those letters stand for loyal, or returning user, and casual, or new user. If an article is driving more casual readers, then perhaps it's one you should use to draw new users. But if your article is driving more loyal readers, then this is an article that is resonating well with your core audience, and you will see whether each article is more popular with your casual readers or those who have visited your website multiple times in the last month, which can help you determine how you should promote an article. Fourth, you will see a green or red circle with 2 arrows inside. These arrows refer to how much recirculation happens from a specific article. Recirculation is when a reader clicks onto another article from the one they're reading. In general, it's a positive sign, indicating a reader is interested in reading more of your coverage. So articles with higher levels of recirculation are shown in green, and those with lower levels are shown in red. Fifth and last, you will see another green or red circle with a little logo that looks like a speedometer. It is a speedometer, but the speed is your web page's speed. Articles that are loading slowly will appear in red, so you can work on fixing them so you don't lose readers while they are waiting for the article to appear. For more on that topic, check out our lesson on Core Web Vitals. Before we move on to the rest of the tool, I'd like to highlight a neat visualization, which you can adopt by clicking the Launch Newsroom View button. The Newsroom View was built to provide a visual of all articles that are currently trending on your publication. In full screen mode, it can be used as a display to ensure that the entire newsroom is aware of what is trending in any given moment and to drive further newsroom involvement with the data. The data will refresh automatically every 180 seconds while in this view. Now, if you go back to the homepage of the tool and keep scrolling down the page, you will see similar information for many more articles. If you click on any article, you will get even more detailed information, such as the most popular geographic locations for reading this article, the most common sources of traffic to the article, the split among people reading it on desktop versus a mobile device, and the average scroll depth, or how far into the article most readers go before leaving. Lastly, on the right-hand side of the page, you can see similar information, but aggregated across your entire news site. So it'll show you how many readers you have on the entire site, and information about those readers. Next, let's take a look at the Realtime Video Performance tab, which you can select on the left-hand menu. This section focuses specifically on the performance of news videos on your site. It shows information on each video's number of real-time viewers, the completion rate, unmute rate, full screen rate, and other data points that can help you determine how engaged an audience is with your video coverage. On a related topic, if you're interested in exploring more about how to launch a YouTube channel as a news organization, or how to increase traffic to videos on your site, check out our other dedicated videos on those topics. So far, we've shown you data that is either a real-time or very recent snapshot of what's happening on your news website. But what if you want to understand your historic performance? If you click on the Historic Performance tab, you can see information across a longer time horizon. For instance, here you see the top performing and lowest performing articles across the past 30 days. This is based on a metric we developed called the Content Engagement Rank that incorporates all sorts of different data points, including page views, recirculation, and percentage of loyal readers. This should allow you to quickly identify stories that have impacted your audience in more meaningful ways. We can filter these results based on the topic of the article or video, and even by the author, if that information is captured in Google Analytics. Lastly, we've incorporated information from Google's search engine. Select Trends in your region on the left-hand menu, and you'll see real-time search trends. This will show you which searches are currently trending in real time. You can further filter these searches into categories like top stories, business, entertainment, health, and science/technology. You can also modify which country to focus on by using the filter at the top. The data is coming from Google Trends, a website that analyzes the popularity of top search queries across various regions and languages. We also show top videos on YouTube to provide inspiration for topics that audiences in your geography are interested in right now. That's all for this video, but this is one of many videos that the Google News Initiative has created to help news organizations navigate different topics. If you're interested in collaborating with us, the Google News Initiative provides free-of-cost, in-depth coaching to groups of news organizations around the world through our labs. You can learn more and apply on our website, g.co/newsinitiative. Thank you, and please share any questions or feedback at contactgni@google.com. Good luck!